Johnny and Grizzle. There was once a poor farmer who had two children named Johnny and Grizzle. Now things grew worse and worse for the farmer till he could scarcely earn enough to eat and drink. All his crops went to pay rent and taxes. So one night he said to his wife, "Betty, my dear, I really do not know what to do. There is scarcely anything in the house to eat, and in a few days we shall all be starving. What I think of doing is to take the poor lad and lassie into the forest and leave them there. If somebody finds them, they will surely keep them alive, and if nobody finds them, they might as well die there as here. I cannot see any other way. It is their lives or ours, and if we die, what can become of them?" "No, no, father," said the farmer's wife. "Wait but a few days and perhaps something will turn up. We have waited and things are getting worse every day. If we wait much longer, we shall all be dead." "No, I am determined on it. Tomorrow the children to the forest." Now it happened that Johnny was awake in the next room and heard his father and his mother talking. He said nothing but thought and thought and thought. And early next morning he went out and picked a large number of bright colored pebbles and put them in his pocket. After breakfast, which consisted of bread and water, the farmer said to Johnny and Grizzle, "Come, my dears, I'm going to take you for a walk," and with that he went with them into the forest nearby. Johnny said nothing, but dropped one of his pebbles at every turning, which would show him the way back. When they got far into the forest, the farmer said to the children, "My dears, I have to go and get something. Stay here and don't go away, and I'll soon come back. Give me a kiss, children." And with that he hurried away and went back home by another road. After a time Grizzle began to cry and said, "Where's father? Where's father? We can't get home. We can't get home." But Johnny said, "Never mind, Grizzle, I can take you home. You just follow me." So Johnny looked out for the pebbles he had dropped, and found them at each turn of the road, and a little after midday got home and asked their mother for their dinner. "There's nothing in the house, children, but you can go and get some water from the well and, please God, we'll have bread in the morning." When the farmer came home he was astonished to find that the children had found their way home, and could not imagine how they had done so. But at night he said to his wife, "Betty, my dear, I do not know how the children came home, but that does not make any difference. I cannot bear to see them starve before my eyes. Better that they should starve in the forest. I will take them there again tomorrow." Johnny heard all this and crept downstairs and put some more pebbles into his pocket. And though the farmer took them this time further into the forest, the same thing occurred as the day before. But this time Grizzle said to her mother and father, "Johnny did such a funny thing. Whenever we turned a new road he dropped pebbles. Wasn't that funny? And when we came back he looked for the pebbles, and there they were. They had not moved." Then the farmer knew how he had been done, and as evening came on he locked all the doors so that Johnny could not get out to get any pebbles. In the morning he gave them a hunk of bread as before for their breakfast and told them he was going to take them into the nice forest to get Grizzle later bread. But Johnny put his into his pocket, and when they got inside the forest at every turning he dropped a few crumbs of his bread. When his father left then he tried to trace his way back by means of these crumbs, but, alas, in the lackaday, the little birds had seen the crumbs and eaten them all up. And when Johnny went to search for them they had all disappeared. So they wondered and they wondered, more and more hungry all the time, till they came to a glade in which there was a funny little house. And what do you think it was made of? The door was made of butterscotch, the windows of sugar candy, the bricks were all chocolate greens, the pillars of lollipops, and the roof of gingerbread. No sooner had the children seen this funny little house than they rushed up to it and commenced to pick pieces off the door, and take out some of the bricks, while Johnny climbed on Grizzle's back, and tore off some of the roof. What was that made of? Just as they were eating all this the door opened and the little old woman, with red eyes, came out and said,